Hello students, in this video we will discuss about important topics on computer forensics and mobile forensics so that you can understand what are the main important things and what are the points you should keep in mind before starting investigation. I have created a document, so here I mentioned that important information before starting computer or mobile forensic investigation. First, I have mentioned computer forensics and then mobile. We will discuss on these topics one by one. I will just explain these things, then I will come to these topics. Okay. So before going to any field or any crime scene, you should be ready with your complete kit. There are lot of mobile. It can be there are many machines, but you should be prepare. So this is the complete ready kit, and you can note it down. First, you should have all power cables, or power cables means SATA power cable, ID power cable, micro, mini and etc. Some generic ports are available, so that you should have all these type of power cables in your kit. Then second thing is tape, like it should be white tape, so that you can paste on any device from which you will acquire data and mention by using marker and Faraday box for mobile and storage SSD, USB and hard drive, so that at the same way if you want to acquire data very fast, then I will suggest always keep SSD in your kit. If you have SSD, that will be fine, but I would suggest keep SSD always in your complete kit. A reason is this device can be destroyed, or little vibration can be destroy your complete digital forensic evidence. Seizing materials you should have, like a stamp and everything, and devices like for computer forensics, disk duplicators, and you fight for mobile forensics, and write blocker for blocking read and write on your data, and adapters and other devices. We will discuss later. When I will discuss this, then I will tell you what is this type of things. Then dongle, you should have always keep your bootable OS. It can be Kali Linux, so that you can boot system forensically and use your license dongle. Like if we have NKS portable, just insert it and run, then you can acquire image from there. And camera also, so that you can take a picture of all devices, and marker and label strip. So that you can label every device which is available in crime scene. For crime scene, if you want to see, I will just sharing images I have, this one. For example, if you are going on any crime scene location, and if this will be location, then you have to take a pictures, then label everything, then you need to prepare everything, like you need to mention everything on chain of custody. Chain of custody is just a sharing. Okay. Here it is. This is the chain of custody form. This is only simple template. Just prepare template as per your organization. This is a sample template, so I'm just explaining this. For example, if I have collected 5 devices, then I will mention here like item 1, then quantity 1, then quantity, how much hard drive, and then description like serial number and condition, damaged or marks or scratches, and company name and power supply mode. I will mention everything. Like for example, if I have this hard drive, if I'll have this hard drive, then I will mention that this is a Western Digital 1 TB hard drive. Serial number is here. This one. As you can see, this is serial number. You need to mention everything. And at the last of the document, at the bottom of document, you will mention SSE and your signature, so that you can approve or you can notify the SSE person that you are collecting data from SSE premises. Okay, these are the main things which should be in your complete kit. If you want to see a complete kit, how should be look like, this is a computer forensics kit. This is write blocker, this is disk duplicator, these are the all power cables and ID power cable. You can see this is a power cable. All things are available here. Small adapters for small hard drives, and this is the power cable also. So you can take an example by this image. For mobile forensics, you can see here, this is the UFED classic, and these are the OR mobile cable which support almost all type of mobile connectors. You can see these are all checks are available. Okay, so we have completed the kit, like which type of item you should carry in your complete kit. Computer forensic mobile kit, you should carry a complete computer forensic kit and a complete mobile forensic kit. Always remember it, never forget these things before going on any crime scene or investigation. So let's talk about computer forensic. When you have complete kit and now you are going for computer forensic investigation, you have, for example, you have this computer and you want to acquire data from this PC. You see, just I'm giving an example, and I will give another example by this image. First thing is, this is a PC, and on crime scene you found that this PC is running. What are the main functions and what are the main actions you will perform in crime scene? First, you will label everything. You can see this is labeled, and then you need to run forensic imager on that PC if system is live. Okay, you can use FTK imager, you can use NKS imager, whatever you have available in your pen drive. Then you can acquire RAM data and hard drive data. Make sure you are acquiring data bit by bit so that you can collect a complete data from suspected PC. Okay, so first I have explained, if you have a running PC, what will you do? First, you will capture RAM data. Second is, you will capture complete hard drive data. Now second option is in computer forensics, if you have a offline storage, like if you have this hard drive and you are making a master copy and secondary copy by this device, which one is this one, Most of the time I have used this kit, so I recommend this duplicator for everyone who want to use it, because most of the time I have used it. This is really handy and intuitive to use. Okay, so this is a disk duplicator, and this is a power adapter which used to power up this machine, and these are the cables to power the hard drive. So always keep suspected hard drive on left side, always keep. And in this device, this is also option that source will be mentioned here and destination will be here. So as the same way I have learned and following the same in everywhere, like in this image you can see this guy have kept this hard drive on left side, and by another cable he's connected this storage to PC so that he can examine this hard drive by this write blocker. This is a write blocker. This is a Tableau write blocker. So as the same way, if you will acquire hard drive, then always keep that suspected hard drive left side, and it will be if you will do on daily practice, then you will understand that after acquiring image, most of the time I have seen that after acquiring, what the forensic examiner do after acquiring image, there will be a little bit confusion that which drive should be on left, which drive should be right. So make it your habit, always keep suspected hard drive on left side, and always keep your destination or master, creating a master copy and secondary copy on right side. Then it will be easy to understand whenever you will do your computer forensic investigation. Okay, always keep your hard drive on left, then destination, where are you copying the data, it should be on right side. Second thing is, I have highlighted these options because if you are creating a master copy or secondary copy, always make sure that if suspected hard drive has 1 TB, then always use 2 TB on right side. And if you have a mobile, if you are acquiring data from mobile, you can see as the same way, left side is for suspected device and right side is for investigation device. Alright, so for computer forensic, always keep remember that chain of custody should be proper filled and maintain everything and keep it unique and fill complete information that from where this device is collected, which is what was the location, SSE name, I can say suspected person name. Okay, SSE name can be a organization, SSE can be a person, SSE can be a company. Okay, that's why normally we say SSE. And storage, always keep minimum 2 TB hard drive in your complete kit, then go for crime scene. Okay, at least 2 TB hard drive and at least 128 GB USB. Okay, so we have, I hope you have completed what I want to say. If still there will be any confusion, if you want to learn how to perform investigation, then we have already create a video, how to acquire image, how to do analysis. You can watch over there. This video we are only creating for to share important information so that you can understand what should you do before any computer forensics or mobile forensic investigation. So we have completed this one. Now I'm coming on mobile forensics. Most of the time I have seen that there are bunch of mobiles brand are launching their new and latest version of mobiles. Okay, so first of all, in your mobile forensic kit, this one, you should carry a complete kit like a mobile forensic device, cables you can see, and these are the adapters and power cables so that we can power up the mobile by this device and acquire data from mobile. And as the same way, this is the same thing, always keep suspected or SSC device on left, and on right side always keep your USB hard drive SSD where you are copying the data, right? And second thing is, if you have a list of mobiles, because whenever you will launch, whenever you will power on this device, it can be that available mobile which you are holding to acquire data from that mobile is not listed in mobile forensic device. So in that case, what will you do? Because this is really important. Whenever you will be in a crime scene, you have very less time to acquire everything. So without wasting time, I'm suggesting, for example, in your mobile forensic device, Galaxy M21 is not listed and other models are listed. So in that case, do one thing. If M21 is not available, just choose another one like Galaxy A22, because what happens is, whenever you will select this device, this computer forensic device will read that mobile and acquire data from that mobile. I hope you will understand everything. Take a quick revision. In computer forensic, always keep your all devices and checklist ready so that you can be prepared yourself before going on any crime scene. So I have explained everything, like you should have power cables, tape, header bags, storage, seizing material, device like disk duplicator, mobile forensic tool, UFED, write blocker, adapter, etc. Dongle, in case FTK dongles, you should carry bootable OS, USB, camera, marker, label stripe and chain of custody form. And then we have discussed computer forensic, how and best practice to acquire data, like you should always keep suspected hard drive on left and your hard drive should be on right side. As the same way, always keep suspected device, mobile device on left and your destiny will be on right side. So that's all on this video. Thank you.